The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, 7th chapter, text number 4, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on the 10th of August, 1974, in Vrindavan, India.
Earth, water, fire, air, ether, mind, intelligence, and false ego. Altogether, these eight comprise my separated material energies.
So, bhumi rāpanalo vāyu, khaṁ mana buddhi revacha, ahankāra, itiyaṁ me bhinnā prakriti astala. Bhinnā means separated. Separated means, Krishna explains in the Bhagavad Gita that maya tatamidam sarvam jagat abhakta murtina. Krishna is everywhere, as it is confirmed in the Brahma Samhita. Ekapasau rachayatum jagadanna koti yat shakti rasti jagadanna chayajadantam annantarastham paramanushayantarastham govindam adipurusam tamaham bhajam. Krishna, by his one plenary portion, when we say of Krishna, Krishna is not alone. Krishna has unlimited expansion. Just like one expansion is Paramatma, Ishara Sarvabhutanam Riddhesi Arjuna Tushtati. Krishna expands himself. There are millions and trillions of living entities. Anantaya Kalpa. The living entity is such an Anantaya Kalpa. So Krishna's expansion is also ananta. Not only within the heart of all living entities, but He is within the atom. Annantarastham paramanutayam. But this is only one plenary portion expansion of Krishna. That one in the morning we are studying. So to understand Krishna philosophically or in truth, he requires little intelligence. Therefore Krishna says, manushyanam sahasreshu kasyajatasthi jatatam visiddhyam. So, Krishna expands by energy, one of the energy, external energy. Therefore it is called apara. Krishna will explain in the next verse, aparayam, inferior energy. For Krishna, there is no superior inferior. But for us, it is superior and inferior. Because Krishna is the Supreme Spirit Soul. Take for example, just like electricity is producing heat and cool off. There is refrigerator that is being worked out by the electric energy, and the heater is also being worked out by the electric energy. So we may distinguish this, that this is heat and this is cold. But for Krishna, there is no such distinction. That will be understood by further explanation of this chapter. So these energies, the external energy, Krishna said, they are separated. Separated means you cannot perceive Krishna directly from this energy. all materialistic scientists, they cannot understand that earth is also Krishna's energy, water is also Krishna's energy, fire is also Krishna's energy. But their energy, that they can understand. They are accepting, the scientists, they are accepting that these are different energies, but whose energy, that they do not know. Therefore, Krishna is explaining here this, that it is my energy, separated energy. If we analytically study how water can be energy of Krishna, we should study Krishna and Krishna's energy very intelligently. Where from this vast water of ocean came into existence. But we can understand from Bhagavad Gita that this vast water has come from Krishna's energy. Now try to understand how Krishna's energy can produce so large amount of water. So far I am concerned, I study in this way, that we produce perspiration from our body. That perspiration may be 1 ounce of water, but that is produced from my body. But Krishna has got inconceivable energy. I have got also inconceivable energy. How the water is coming out, I do not know. It is inconceivable. But it is coming out, that's a fact. So, I am a very small, teeny living entity. If I can produce, because I am always limited, therefore my energy is also limited. But Krishna is unlimited, so he can produce water from the perspiration of his body unlimited. We have to understand like that, otherwise it is not possible to understand how water came from the energy of Krishna. It is coming from the living entity. Water is not coming from matter. Just like your perspiration is not coming. When the body is dead, the water is not coming. But so long you are living, the perspiration is there. Therefore, the source of all material elements is originally the Supreme Life, not matter. That is explained here. Bhumi rapa nalo bhai. But they are separated. How they are separated? That is explained in a defined verse. Maya tatamidam sarvam jagat abhakta murtina masthani sarva bhutan naham tesu avasthita. It is separated because in this material world you cannot directly perceive the presence of the Supreme Personality of God. Naham tesu avasthita. I am not present there. Although it is coming from my energy, still I am not present there. This is simultaneously one and different philosophy. Here, Krishna says that ahankara ityangme bhinna pratityo. Everything is finite. Just like the heart is grosser than the water. Water finite. Earth cannot move, but water can move. Therefore, it is finite. And finer than the earth is the fire. And finer than the fire is air. And finer than the air is ether. And finer than the ether is the mind. And finer than the mind is intelligence. And finer than intelligence is my identity, ahankar. And finer than the ahankar is the soul. You have to study soul, finer, 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 finer. It is also stated in the Bhagavad Gita in another place that indriyani pararahu indriyabha parammana manasastu paro buddhi in this way, finer, finer. And the soul is very small magnitude fine. Kesagra sadhvagas satadha kulkitasas. So, everything is explained in the Srimad Bhagavad Gita. If we accept, then we get full knowledge. The beginning of the Bhagavad Gita, in this chapter, Krishna says, asaṃsayaṃ samagraṃ vā yathāgāśya-sitarśaṃ, without any doubt, and in full, as you can understand me, I am going to explain. So, these five elements, gross elements, mumira-panala-vāyu-khaṃ, and finer than mana-buddhi-ahankar, mind, intelligence, and false ego. False ego means I am identifying with this matter, which I am not. Therefore, ahankar, this ahankar is false ahankar, which I am not. I am accepting that I am this body, but actually I am not. Therefore, I am saying it is false ego. Real ahankar is aham brahman. There is also ahankar. Ahankar cannot be abolished. Ahankar will be there. But ahankar has to be cleansed. Therefore, bhakti marga, the path of bhakti yoga, is the cleansing process, clearing process. Cheta dhatvana marjanam. Everything is there, but it has to be cleansed. That is Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's mission. By chanting the Hare Krishna mantra, you will be able to cleanse your misconception of life. Misconception of life is that I am this matter. This is ahankar, false ahankar. But I am actually not this matter. I am spirit soul. Therefore, pure ahankar is aham brahman, spirit soul. That is the beginning of understanding. Aham brahmasmi, that is also explained in the Bhagavad Gita, that brahma bhuta prasannātmā na sochati na kāṁ. If one understands this fact, that I am not this material body, I am a spirit soul, that is called brahma bhuta. So gradually, by understanding the teachings of Bhagavad Gita and practicing it in life, we shall very easily understand the Atma-tattam. That is the real business of human life. Unfortunately, we are not interested in the matter of understanding Atma-tattam. Śrutavyādi-nirājendra nirāṁ santi sahasrat. Sukadeva Goswami said, my dear king, you are speaking to Maharaj Parikshit that for ordinary man there are many subject matter of hearing. Śrutavyādini. Śrutavya means the subject matter for hearing. So Sukadeva Goswami said, for the ordinary man, who is that ordinary man? Apashtatam atmatattam. Apashtatam. One who has no interest to see what he is. Everyone is under this contemplation that he is this body, and his bodily interest is the prime interest. But nobody sees the atmatattam. Therefore, Sukadeva Goswami said, śrutavyādini rājendra nirāṁ santi sahasrasa. We have got so many books, so many newspapers, so many magazines we hear and read, but we are not interested in hearing Bhagavad Gita or Śrīmad Bhāgavatam, where ātma-tattvam, the science of soul, is described. So why they are not interested? The apushtam atmadattam griheshu grihemedana. Griheshu, a household life, they are thinking this is life. Tatala saikate baribindu sama suta mita ramani samadhi. Vidyapati, a great poet, Vaishnava poet, he has sung that we are happy within this material world. How? Suta mita ramani samadhi. Suta means children, and mita means friend, and ramani means woman. So actually, our material life existing is society, friendship and love. If there are nice, beautiful women at home, children and friends, we are taking, this is our life. But that is not life. Real life is to understand what I am. Atmatattva. Atmatattva. Without understanding, Atmatattva, the life is failure. Therefore, Vidyapati Singh, Tatala Saitate Baribindu Sama, Suta Mita Ramani Samaj. We have created the society, friendship and love in this material world for becoming happy. Everyone wants to be happy because that is his natural inclination. Anandamaya Vyasat. As Krishna is happy always, we see Krishna is enjoying his life with Srimati Radharani and the gopi or the cowherd boy or his father, mother, that is the spiritual, everything. Ananda Chinmaya Rasa Pratibhavitali, that is Ananda Chin. A similar imitation here in this material world, the same thing, sutamita ramani samadhi, but it is false. Just like you see water in the desert, you see there is vast mass of water in the desert, and the animal falsely go to drink the water and die. Similarly, in this material world, this sutamita ramani samadhi, what we are trying to become happy, that is like will-o'-the-wisp, false thing. Real life is in the society of Krishna. Bhaktivinoda Thakur therefore says, Krishnel saṃsār kara chāriyanāt. If you enter into the society, friendship and love of Krishna, that is perfection. Not in this false, humir upon or by. They are separated energy. This is also made by the Krishna's energy. But it is separate reflection. False reflection, chayeva. Chayeva means just like shadow. Just like you see your face in the mirror. But it is not actually the face. It is simply the face is here and the shadow is there. Similarly, this material world, made of bhumi, rapa, analabai, bhangamana buddhi, they are just like reflection of the real life in the spiritual world. Therefore it is called separated energy. Why Krishna says? Krishna says here that bhinna, bhinna means separate. The example I have already sometimes I give, just like I speak in the tape recorder. When you replay the tape recorder, the same voice will come. But that is not myself. That is my separated energy. With my energy I have spoken something, I have vibrated some sound that is recorded in the tape. When it is played back, it produces exactly the same sound, but still it is separated from. Try to understand, this material world is like that. Bhinna, separate. The real life is in the spiritual world. Therefore in the Srimad Bhagavatam, it is said, Satyam Param Dhimahi. The real truth, the absolute truth. I am offering my obeisances to the absolute truth. So Krishna is the absolute truth. Krishna is explaining himself. If we want to understand Krishna, then instead of speculating about Krishna, better take what Krishna teaching himself. That will be perfect. So the real understanding of Krishna, that this material world is also Krishna. But we do not know how to use it for Krishna. If you take to that process, Krishna's energy should be for Krishna's purpose. That is Vaishnava philosophy. Vaishnava philosophy never says that this world is false. Why it is false? It is not false. As the Mayavadi philosopher says, that Brahma Satta Jagan Mithya. No. Why Jagan Mithya? Just like this temple is constructed. If somebody says, yes, it is very nicely constructed, but it is all false. Shall I be happy? No. And actually, why it is false? It is not false. It is Krishna's energy. The Bhumi Rapa Ralabai. What is this temple? This temple is combination of the Bhumi Rapa Ralabai. Tejo Bharimit Vinimayam. This brick. What is this brick? Brick means you take earth, mix with water, and put into the fire, it becomes brick. And there is air. So, it is Krishna's energy. It is not material. It is Krishna's energy. Because the philosophy is that Krishna's energy should be used for Krishna's purpose, namely the spiritual. That is our philosophy. Srila Rupa Goswami gives this formula. Prapanchitataya buddhya hari sambandhi vastuna mumukshubi parityaga phalgu vairaga tattva. Phalgu vairaga, phalgu means false. The phalgu from river phalgu is here in India. There is a river phalgu. You will see that there is no water on the surface of the river. But if you push your hand within the sand, you'll get water. So phalgu vairaga means that I am giving up, renouncing everything superficially. But within me there is a desire how to become God. I am giving up, but I cannot give up this desire. There is big philosophy on this point. They are trying to become one with God. But a devotee does not try to become one with God or separated from God. They are satisfied. In whatever condition God keeps him, he is satisfied. So, separated energy, in this way you have to understand that although this energy is separated from Krishna, it can be used for Krishna. And when it is used for Krishna, then it is spiritual. It is no more material. Material means forgetfulness. Karmis are constructing big houses, skyscraper houses. The purpose is to enjoy himself. The same thing, Bhumi Rapa Ralabai, mixing together brick or stone or cement. If it is used for Krishna, then it is Yukta Vairagya. Anāsaktasya viṣayāt yathāraṁ upajanyata nirbandhi Krishna sambandha yukta vairāgyam uccyate. Our philosophy is that although this material world, Bhumi Rapa Ralabai, they are separated from Krishna, we can use it for Krishna. That's like the same example. The tape recorder, it is material, but it can be used for Krishna's purpose. We are writing books, recording in the tape recorder. That's nirbandhe Krishna sambandha yukta vairagya uccyate. There is no need of giving up This bhumi rapa analabai, as Mayavadi philosopher said. You can utilize, after all it is Krishna's energy. This is the best philosophy. That one man's property should be used for the proprietor. That is the best use. So, we do not neglect this bhumi rapa, although it is separated energy, that when we reconnect in the service of the Lord, it becomes spiritual. It requires little time to understand. The example, as we have given many times, that you put an iron rod in the fire, it becomes warm, warmer, warmer, warmer. Then when it is red hot, it is no longer iron rod, but it is fire. Similarly, everything in this material world, mumi rapa analabhai, although it is separated from Krishna, if you engage it in the service of Krishna, it is no more material, it is spiritual. This is the philosophy of Vaishnava. Nirbandhi Krishna Sambandha Jukta Vaidyalo Mitsati. So this is Krishna consciousness. If we always remember that everything, whatever we are using, that is Krishna's energy. We are also Krishna's energy. Jiva Bhuta, that will be expressed in the next verse. Aparayam itastu vidhme prakitin para. Another prakriti, para prakriti. Spiritual energy. What is that? Jiva Bhuta, Mahabhava Jaidam Dhaja. So, both of us. The matter is also Krishna's energy. And the spirit soul is also Krishna's energy. And there is another spiritual world. That is also Krishna's energy. Everything is Krishna's energy. So, when the spiritual energy is engaged in the service of Krishna in this material energy, bhumi rapa analabhai, that also becomes converted into spiritual energy exactly like that iron rod converted into fire. So it requires intelligence if you think how all things can be changed into spiritual world. That is Krishna consciousness moment. Thank you very much.